Good evening, welcome to Inside Out. I'm Matt Huffman.
And I'm Briley Boyce.
And we're rolling into the big episode number 5.
Yeah, Cinco.
Cinco, there you go. A little cultural differentiation right there. Differentiation, that's a word. But we have a busy show tonight, actually. We're going to have Lane talking to us a little bit about the news over here.
I have my interview with Morgan Hunter all the way from New Zealand.
I'll be talking to the professor and director of this new event coming up on the campus, Ryan Stander, this new art event.
Awesome.
Opening tonight.
Julio has his sports.
Alex Coleman's going to have the weather.
And that's going to be our show.
I think that's it. Okay. Yeah. Well, Lane, why don't you talk to me about what's going on in local news tonight?
Well, we got a lot going on. SGA, Student Government Association, held their elections yesterday. So congratulations to everyone that got the positions they wanted.
Did the candidate with the memes win her position that she was marketing?
Just a little bit.
Okay.
I'm not entirely sure who you're referencing there, to be honest, because I wasn't paying attention to the memes so much. But
okay. Hey.
It's all right.
Yeah, keep up. Keep up.
Minot State Student Government Association elections were held yesterday, and the winners have been announced. The 2017 to 2018 SGA officers include Aaron Richard as president, Caitlin Walker as vice president of finance, Annika Kraft as vice president of internal affairs, Bicalba G. Marie is vice president of state affairs, sorry if I butchered that name a little bit, and Paula Kabating as vice president of student outreach. Some of the non-executive positions were also filled during this election, but there are still a number of open positions available. Notably, the College of Arts and Sciences did not gain any representatives this time around. The next election to fill vacant roles will be at the start of next semester. With spring break practically here, signing up for classes is the last thing students want to be thinking about.
We have a lot to deal with each semester. Signing up for next semester's classes is on that list of things to do. Luckily, professors like Dr. Christina Paxman are ready to help.
Well, the first thing you want to do is put in your calendar that starting on Tuesday, March 21st is registration. And the best thing you can do to prepare for that is actually log into your Campus Connection account. And there is a tab called Academic Requirements. And if you click that, that's going to list out 3 different things for you. So first it will tell you your gen ed requirements, and it shows clearly in red anything that's outstanding. Then it's going to show your major requirements, and then also any requirements for a minor and or concentration. So that's kind of where you know where you're at for what you need to be taking during the fall semester.
Dr. Paxman encourages her advisees to come in and make a plan as soon as possible.
Anytime we can do planning, it's super helpful because you never really know where a hiccup is going to come about. And also to make sure you're not in your last semester when you find out, oh, I need to take this class, and you were just getting ready to walk or something like that. So it's really important to register ASAP. So classes that do not have high enrollment will be canceled.
Students should sign up for a meeting with their advisor as soon as possible. Minot State's record-setting forward is moving on to the Women's Soccer League. Alex Coleman has more on the story.
For the last 2 years, Ninja Ramirez has been dominating the NSIC and smashing school records, but she hasn't hit her peak yet.
It's nice to come in and break records and like keep the tradition going, but I still want to like get better and go further.
Numbers don't lie for Ramirez's career stat line, earning her an invite to the next level.
I wanted to play at that level since I was younger, and then I feel like moving up here, it kind of pushed me down a little bit, but then again, the stats here was something that really helped me, so that is one of my goals is to get there, but so we'll see in a couple weeks.
Coming off the bench for the Washington Spirit will be unfamiliar territory for Ramirez, but she says she's ready for her new role.
I'm going to come in obviously knowing that I'm going to be starting off the bench, and my thing is now when I come into the game, I have to make a difference. I have to make an impact versus, just starting from what I'm used to.
Ramirez has some big boots to fill, but she has some big-time players in the league that can teach her a thing or two.
I guess as far as the team that I have got invited to, Crystal Dunn is up top, so I guess that is someone to look up to because that's a huge spot to fill. She's really, really good, and, that's a lot of pressure going in, especially knowing that the fans, that was her favorite player. So me coming in, that being my position, it's I gotta work hard.
Ramirez credits coach Jason Spain and the Beaver soccer team for giving her the tools to fulfill a dream playing professionally. For NBC North Dakota Sports, I'm Alex Coleman.
Ramirez will be playing her first game on March 18th against Penn State. Over spring break, Minot State's Division of Science will be hosting a regional science Olympiad. On Monday, March 13th, middle and high school students are invited to participate. There are currently 17 B Division teams and 12 C Division teams signed up. Participating schools include Bishop Ryan, Century High School, Eric Ramstad, Ned Rose, and many others from around the state. There are 18 sessions planned for each group that cover a variety of different scientific topics. The winners of the competition will advance to the state competition in April. So we've got spring break right around the corner, Matt. Any special plans for you?
A whole lot of Minot. Just taking in this, every day's a vacation when you live here. Come on.
Yeah, it really
obviously
is.
But the printmaking studio has had a busy semester preparing to roll out the Lasting Influence show and lecture tonight, almost immediately after this interview. Thank you for joining us. I'm with MSU professor and head coordinator of the event, Ryan Standard. How are you doing tonight?
Doing well. Thanks for having me.
So the two big names of this exhibit are John Carricker and David Dreisbach. What can you tell us about these two as we show our viewers at home some of the pieces that are going to be presented around campus?
Well, both are known as artists and educators. John was my printmaking professor.
Okay.
And so I spent a lot of time with him in my undergrad. John's undergraduate printmaking professor is the other artist, David Dreisbach. And so there's kind of this nice chain of influence coming through all the artists. And actually, both of them studied with the same person in graduate school, Maurizio Lozansky at the University of Iowa. And so tonight's lecture will try and pull some of these threads of influence together.
Absolutely. And the lecture tonight is going to be you and Professor Micah Bloom, and then multiple students, I understand, too, correct?
Yeah, so Micah will talk about, show other artists, mm-hmm. kind of in this chain of how we artists look at other artists and are influenced by them.
Yep.
Professor Dan Kahn from the Education Department will talk about teaching and mentoring from kind of from his perspective or his discipline.
Okay.
And then students will also talk on different aspects.
Absolutely. So then kind of on that note, let's talk about the relationship between the educator and the student and how that kind of plays into your role as a professor slash mentor here at Minot State University.
I think when I was a student, I didn't think too much about the education process, the way that John taught me. Now as a teacher, I think more and more about the strong mentors and teachers that I've had in my life and trying to emulate what I appreciated about them. And studying, reading about John and reading about his mentors has given me some new ideas about teaching, and that's yeah. exciting. So I hope that I can live up to their influence.
I think you're doing all right, but it's interesting too, coming from like the perspective of like the art department, more so maybe not as like the traditional like science and your math, you know, you're really mm-hmm. like involved the step-by-step process with how these students are growing personally and mm-hmm. creating stuff. You have to kind of teach it from you, not the book,
right?
Essentially. But can you talk a little bit about the logistics that went into making this whole grand event happen? I know you guys have stuff all over the campus, from what I understand.
Yeah, so MSU has three galleries now, which is pretty amazing for a campus of our size. UND only has one.
Hey, there you go. Hey, take that, UND.
That's right.
Take that.
We have three, and the Flattail Gallery is in the administrative building, Hartnett Hall Gallery, and the Library Gallery. And John's in the Library Gallery, and Dreisbach is in the other two. I've been working with the Dreisbach family for about 3 years, and the collection is a donation from them. So we've received about 70 prints from them,
wow.
and which is a pretty major yeah. addition to MSU collection. And Carricker's work is on loan, and we've been working with that family for about a year and a half to get it. But it's countless hours of framing and matting
yeah.
and publicity, and so it's a lot of work that goes into. And just hanging the show takes a lot of time.
Oh, yeah, I guess it's the manual labor.
Yes.
The manual labor that goes into art that we often forget about sometimes. But so on a little more personal note, are there any other kind of side projects that you're working on outside of the exhibit right now? I know Cassie Stauffer mentioned that you were going to be exhibiting at the For the Love of the Arts.
Yeah, so I'll be doing that. I just got back from Dayton, Ohio. I had an exhibit opening out there at the University of Dayton.
Mm-hmm.
And the spring break, it's hard to make art as a professor. You're always so busy. So I'm hoping I'll have a little window that I might actually get to make art myself.
Hey, there you go. I mean, all you can ask for is a little free time over spring break.
That's right. Right?
So is there anything else you'd like to add tonight, Ryan?
The show will be up for the rest of the month. Mm-hmm. And so if you can't make it tonight to the lecture and the reception, it'll be up till the end of March. And all the Dreisbach prints will be in the permanent collection. So they will occasionally come out mm-hmm. at other exhibits as well.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for joining me tonight, Ryan. And after Underwriters, we're going to go to Julio with sports, Bradley Boyce with her interview with Morgan Hunter, former basketball player for Minot State University, and Alex Coleman with the weather.
All American Trophies for all your screen printing and embroidery needs.
Art Main, women's clothing, accessories, and art supplies located 13 Main Street, South Minot.
Buffalo Wings and Rings, the sports restaurant experience, located in South Minot.
Badlands Bar and Grill, everyone's welcome and is our special guest, located in Southwest Minot.
Fiance Bridal, located in downtown Minot, or shop online.
KCJB, 9:10 a.m., Minot's news and information station.
Buffalo Wild Wings, wings, beer, sports, located in 3820 South Broadway.
KIZZ-FM, Z94, Minot's only station for today's hit music.
Mix 99.9, Minot's best music mix.
Happy Joe's Pizza and Ice Cream, good times to be together.
KRRZ, 1390 AM, Minot's classic hits.
KZTR, 105.3 The Fox, Minot's rock station.
Jacobson Music, a family-owned business with three locations in Dickinson, Bismarck, and Minot.
KYYX, 97 Kicks FM, Minot's hot new country.
MSU Beaver Hockey. Visit us online at msubeaverhockey.com or on Facebook and Twitter.
Qdoba, easy, on time, full of flavor.
MSU Theater Department, offering the highest quality of entertainment at Minot State.
Ford Communication brings employers, retailers, and other professionals from the Midwest to connect under one roof.
MSU Bookstore, for all of your school supplies and MSU gear, located on campus.
Red and Green, Minot State's official student-run newspaper.
Magic City Hoagies, a locally owned sandwich shop, located in Southwest Minot. Spicy Pie, pizza, grinders, and beer, located at Beaver Ridge Plaza.
Mike Blessum, State Farm Insurance Agent at 11th Avenue, Southwest Minot.
Taco John's, offering fresh tacos, burritos, nachos, and breakfast.
At Minot State, we have students from all over the world. And today, I have the luxury of talking to former basketball player Morgan Hunter, all the way from New Zealand, to tell us how her experience has been at Minot State and what she has planned after her collegiate basketball season, since it's now sadly over. So thank you for being with us here today, Morgan. And from being from a different part of the planet, really, you're so involved with the school. I mean, you just finished playing basketball for us here at Minot State. You're on the SAT committee, involved with student ambassadors, and you're on the Sexual Violence Advisory Committee. That was a mouthful. So how do you do it all?
You know, it's very interesting. In high school, I was really active on campus and I did a lot of things, and so it was only natural for me to come to Minot State and want to do a bunch of different activities other than athletics. And so for me, it kind of comes naturally. I'm used to juggling my time. Time management is something that I'm pretty good at, I think. With being an athlete, you learn to prioritize and time manage pretty well. So it's something I enjoy, so it's not hard for me to do.
And so for the SAC committee, you're the president. What exactly is SAC?
So the SAC committee is the Student Athlete Advisory Committee. We're basically a group of student athletes that have been selected from the respective teams on campus. And we meet every month and we get together and basically discuss what it's like to be a student athlete at Minot State. And then we discuss anything that we think needs to be changed. We are basically the group that voices all the opinions of the student athletes. We try to make change. We try to make it the best experience possible for everyone on campus and off campus, and making it an enjoyable time.
That's awesome. What do you do as president?
So my role as president, I meet with the group every month. It's my job to organize the meetings, I communicate with our athletic director, Andy Cotter, and then also Steve Swenson. He's our compliance officer, and so I'm just kind of that connection between the representatives on the group and the faculty members in the athletic department. And I make the agenda, I make sure that we're doing what we're supposed to be doing, that we're bringing awareness to the initiatives that the NSIC have set out, and just making sure we're organized.
That's awesome. So you always have the inside scoop of what's going on with athletics.
I do.
So is there anything new happening this semester for athletics?
Yeah, there's quite a few new things going on. There's something I'm really excited about, which is our Best Bees. It's the first time we've ever done the Best Bees. It's going to be taking place of the senior banquet that we usually have every year for the senior athletes. So what's going to happen is we're going to kind of have a red carpet event where everybody's going to get dressed up.
Ooh.
And yeah, it's kind of exciting. It's new and different. We're going to vote on a bunch of awards and basically just pay recognition to a lot of the really great athletes that we have at Minot State, give out some awards, have a nice night, do something different to honor the seniors that are leaving as well.
Aww. Well, to shift gears, basketball season just finished, mm-hmm. and unfortunately so did your basketball career. So how are you feeling about being done with everything?
You know, it's been a little bittersweet for me this season. I had a career-ending injury and I tore my Achilles, so I didn't get to play, which was really frustrating, but at the same time, I got to do a lot of other things. I mean, I was very busy and involved on campus, and so not being able to play kind of opened up some time to do other things. But I'm really excited for the new chapter of my life. I'm pursuing higher education, and I'm staying in the United States, and so I have a lot of things to look forward to.
Wow. So, I mean, after you leave Minot to further your education, where are you going? What are you doing with that?
So my plans right now, I've accepted a position at the University of Miami in Ohio. I'm going to be getting my education specialist degree in school psychology. So I'm going to be moving over to Ohio. I'm going to be a Red Hawk. Doesn't really have the same ring as a Beaver, but I'm really excited. So that's my plans.
Wow. So what do you want to do with your master's whenever you do accomplish that?
Mm-hmm. So it takes about 3 years to finish that specialist degree. Afterwards, I plan to stay in America. I don't see myself going home anytime soon, is much to my parents' disappointment. But I want to be here. I love America. I've had a great time since I've been here in North Dakota. So I plan to stay, hopefully get a job and do some travel.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. And I wish you the best of luck with everything, and I'm glad you love America.
Thank you. That's awesome.
So, Julio, the Class B tournament was postponed until today rather than being on Monday.
Right.
I guess it's kind of good for the teams who wanted a couple more practices to, I don't know, just really get that in before the big tournament started. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, definitely. So the North Dakota High School Basketball Class B Region Tournament was supposed to start early this week, Monday, but due to a snow blizzard, it was postponed. The tournament is set to start today here at the Minot State Dome. However, the semifinals and the final game will be held at the Minot Auditorium on Friday and Saturday, March 10th and 11th. Minot State's baseball team have a long weekend ahead as they are set to play against Wayne State, Concordia University, and Winona State in Minneapolis, Minnesota. The women's softball team managed to add some midweek games as they went against Mayville State. The Beavers held their own as they finished with winning both games. Game one with a score of 11-0 and game two being 10-0. Minot State soccer forward Nympho Ramirez was invited to Washington Spirit Pro team camp. Ramirez will be battling for a spot on the Spirit Pro roster over the 4 weeks, but could also make the team's reserve roster. The Minot State Dome helped host as one of the venues for the 2017 North Dakota State Basketball Tournament Special Olympics last week on Friday and Saturday. That marked the 35th consecutive year the tournament was held in Minot, with more than 35 teams and nearly 500 Special Olympic athletes from all over North Dakota. Plenty of Minot State athletes and students helped and volunteered throughout the tournament to show support in this great event. The Minot State women's hockey team are invited to compete in nationals, but just barely made it because of fundings. Here's Chris Tom with the story.
An intense moment for both coaches and athletes, with nationals barely within reach.
We just weren't positive we were going to come down to that last six seed there, because another team was same record, pretty much same difficulty in play, so they could have overcome us at the end of the season. But
We'd been waiting for like a week.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. I mean, we kept finding out like the next day, then the next day, and then they, you know, postponed it like 3 more days. So.
Yeah.
Of course, this doesn't discourage anyone on the team.
This is the first time in Minot State women's history that we're ever going. I'm looking forward to whatever can happen because we just said in practice, like, we've overcome a lot of odds this year and nothing's really been in our favor compared to a team that stacks 20 players on their bench. We have 11. We're going to go out and grab a national championship for Minot State.
We're ready to go play, ready to represent Minot State, on a bigger scale for the women's program.
Yeah, super excited. It's a great opportunity for all of us.
I think it's going to be fun just to show people who we are. We haven't been to nationals before, and I don't think people, you know who we are. Or they don't expect us to do much there, but I think we're going to surprise a lot of teams.
Money is always an issue a team has to worry about. However, this team is putting in overtime.
We're working right up until we leave. Like, we leave Sunday, we work 2 Toros games.
Budgets are still pretty tight. It's going to be interesting to see how things go after we're done with nationals and then how things stack up for next year. I think right after nationals, we already have a Taco John's fundraiser set up for the following season.
Well, because both the men's and the women's team are, you know, club sports, so they're not funded by the school really. So I wouldn't say it's a struggle, but, you know, it's a close call.
Everyone has a reason they think nationals is possible.
I'd like to thank the coaches for everything they've done for us. They really stepped up, brought this program up.
Girls, hard work, dedication, you know, motivation, that's why they succeed.
I mean, the main thing keep me coming back every week is just like how hard the girls work and how bad they want it, you know. If they don't want to be here, then, you know, I don't want to show up. But they really want to be here, and they work their ass off.
Yeah, and the boys team have been a huge help to us.
Oh, they're awesome.
They've been, like, they took us to Colorado, stuff that we couldn't afford to do on our own.
The Beavers take a 20-hour road trip by van, leaving Sunday, March 12th. From all of us at Minot State, good luck at Nationals. Back to you, KMSU.
We definitely do wish the Beavers good luck. And the tournament will be hosted in Columbus, Ohio, March 15th through the 19th. This was Julio with sports.
So it's interesting that they had such a funding issue when, you know, you think of Minot as a big hockey, I don't want to say city necessarily, but town, big hockey town. But next year hopefully won't be a problem after they make it to the Nationals at least once. They should have all the backing that they could possibly need.
Definitely.
But still coming up, we have Alex Coleman with the weather, and we're going to go ahead and throw it to our underwriters.
All-American Trophies, for all your screen printing and embroidery needs.
Art Main, women's clothing, accessories, and art supplies located 13 Main Street, South Minot.
Buffalo Wings and Rings, the sports restaurant experience, located in South Minot.
Badlands Bar and Grill, everyone's welcome and is our special guest, located in Southwest Minot.
Fiance Bridal, located in downtown Minot or shop online.
KCJB, 9:10 a.m., Minot's news and information station.
Buffalo Wild Wings, wings, beer, sports, located in 3820 South Broadway.
KIZZ-FM, Z94, Minot's only station for today's hit music.
Mix 99.9, Minot's best music mix.
Happy Joe's Pizza and Ice Cream, good times to be together.
KRRZ, 1390 AM, Minot's classic hits.
KZTR, 105.3, The Fox, Minot's rock station.
Jacobson Music, a family-owned business with 3 locations in Dickinson, Bismarck, and Minot.
KYYX, 97 Kicks FM, Minot's hot new country.
MSU Beaver Hockey. Visit us online at msubeaverhockey.com or on Facebook and Twitter.
Qdoba, easy, on time, full of flavor.
MSU Theater Department, offering the highest quality of entertainment at Minot State.
Ford Communication brings employers, retailers, and other professionals from the Midwest to connect under one roof.
MSU Bookstore, for all of your school supplies and MSU gear, located on campus.
Red and Green, Minot State's official student-run newspaper.
Magic City Hoagies, a locally owned sandwich shop, located in Southwest Minot. Spicy Pie, pizza, grinders, and beer, located at Beaver Ridge Plaza.
Mike Blessum, State Farm Insurance Agent at 11th Avenue, Southwest Minot.
Taco John's, offering fresh tacos, burritos, nachos, and breakfast.
Welcome back to MSU Inside Out. I'm still Matt Huffman.
And I'm still Briley Boyce.
I'm Alex Coleman. It's my first intro for the night.
Hey, welcome to the show, Alex.
Oh, I appreciate it.
Hey, I mean, it's been a long time. I feel like I haven't seen you all week.
You missed me.
Episode 5, you came back. And I don't know what's going on, but in the studio, it's hot.
It is.
You know, in the studio, it's hot. Outside is not the case. Maybe it's so hot in here because of Briley's warm smile, but that just might be the reason why, because we're all sweating here.
Jacket's coming unbuttoned, folks.
So since I embarrassed myself enough for the evening already, we can just kick right to our first graphic, which is today's almanac. Now, we are just below average for the year for about the precipitation. But with all the snow we're getting this week, we are planning to just hit average. So still moving on till right now, our weather for right now, it is about 7 degrees, but what it really feels like is negative 11 degrees, and that's because of those 60 mile per hour winds heading north. Along with that, you can expect the sun to set tonight around 6:40. Now, the whole state is in a wind chill advisory, so looking at the whole state as a whole, like I said, I just step out the way so you guys can see what the map is looking like. In our area, Minot, it's a wind chill advisory along with the majority of the north central and the majority of the entire western part of the state. And if you look south, southwest, you have the special winter statement and some hazardous weather outlook. You can expect some snow mixed with ice and really high wind. So like I said, if you have to go outside, make sure to bundle up. Roads conditions can get a little sketchy, so pay attention to the road. And like I said, if you don't have to go outside, then I would not advise it. Now, looking towards this weather as a state today, moving on to our next graphic, Grand Forks, 11 degrees with a low of negative 11. Majority of the state is going to be in those negative chills, so bundle up, don't go outside. It is cold. This Minot, 14, Bismarck down to 17, Williston, 10, and then Dickinson, 15 degrees. So cold, and you can only expect it to be just as cold this weekend and maybe even a little bit colder for spring break. So that's what spring break looks like in North Dakota, apparently. So looking at our extended forecast for the weather, like I said, snow, and snow, guys. So hope you guys are ready for it.
I think we are. I think we're all ready for it here. I mean, the North Dakota, but we're gonna go ahead and just jump right to our song of the week. Gotta Get Over by Eric Clapton. Thank you for joining us on MSU Inside Out, and we will look to see you guys next week. One more day, one more truth, but I got to find that well. Feel the roll of the river taking me there. Good Lord, only get you so far, then you got to help yourself.